Okay, in this part we are going to discuss about natural diluents. Natural diluents are also one of the type of excipients. So what are these diluents? Diluents are the substances which are used to enhance the bulk of the dosage form. As such, whenever we are considering the active pharmaceutical ingredient, it cannot be administered directly. So in order to prepare the formulation from active pharmaceutical ingredient, it must be diluted to proper level or to proper concentration to make its formulation. In this case, diluents are going to help us. So diluents are the substances which is going to enhance the bulk of dosage form. So diluents are added in solid, liquid as well as semi-solid formulations. So in liquid preparation, they are going to dilute the preparation, as well as in several preparations, they are going to adjust the proper weight of the formulation, as well as they are very useful in maintaining the volume for ease of administration. Apart from that, diluents are having so many advantages like improved cohesion, direct compression, as well as to increase the flow properties in case of tablet manufacturing, as well as desired weight of the tablet. So diluents are mainly useful in preparation of tablets. So herbal diluents, the first thing we are going to discuss, that is cellulose. Cellulose is also called as arbocel or arbo E460 or sanacel. Cellulose, it is a polysaccharide, and a polysaccharide which is found in most of the cells of the plant. Cellulose is a component of cell wall of the plants, as well as several algae and bacteria. So this particular cellulose, it is chemically inert compound, and it is odorless as well as tasteless. It can be made into the free flowing powder form as well as granular powder form. Cellulose is practically insoluble in water, as well as it is soluble in dilute acids and other organic solvents. Apart from cellulose, it also contains hemicelluloses as well as lignin and pectin, plant derived cellulose. If we consider hemicelluloses, lignin and pectin, they are also form of the cellulose. So cellulose is mainly used as a diluent for tablets, as well as filler for hard gelatin capsules, and it helps in a direct compression of the granules. It can be used as a suspending agent as well. Cellulose is one of the popular herbal excipient in cosmetic as well as food industry, because it is biocompatible excipients. There are several derivatives, chemical derivatives, if we can consider, that is microcrystalline cellulose, that is MCC, as well as carboxymethyl cellulose, that is CMC. These are the popular derivatives of cellulose. Moving towards next diluent, it is lactose. Lactose, it is also called as milk sugar or lactosum. So this particular lactose is a natural disaccharide, and it is obtained from the animal origin. It consists of galactose and glucose. As we said, it is a natural disaccharide mainly obtained from the milk of mammals. And this disaccharide, as we are aware, disaccharides, they are composed of two monosaccharides. So this disaccharide is composed of galactose and glucose. Lactose, it is odorless, crystalline, faint sweet taste powder, and main advantage of lactose, it is water soluble as well as biocompatible, because it is a part of milk, and most of the human beings, they consume milk. So there are very less cases that people are having sensitivity with the milk, but still lactose can be used as an excipient. Lactose is present in the several forms, like anhydrous beta lactose, around 70 to 80%, as well as anhydrous alpha lactose 20 to 30%, and monohydrate lactose, alpha monohydrate lactose. So there are several forms of lactose, and lactose is mainly used in preparation of tablets as well as capsules as a diluent, and it can be used for the dry powdered inhalations. There are several formulations in the powdered form, and simply we have to inhale that powder. Nowadays Cipla is preparing those powdered dosage form for the inhalations. So it need so that particular drug is adsorbed on the diluent, and simply you have to inhale that powder. So dry powder inhalations, lactose can be a great diluent. Apart from that, it can be used in a coating solution along with the sucrose. So likewise, there are so many uses of lactose. Moving towards the next diluent is mannitol. Mannitol, it is also called as manna sugar or D-mannite or mannogen. It is the exudation obtained from the stems of Fraxinus ornus belonging to family Oleaceae. Mainly mannitol is odorless and non-hygroscopic, as well as it is a sweet in taste. Its sweetness potency is similar to glucose and half as sucrose. So mannitol as such, it can be used as a sweetening agent, but rather than using as a sweetening agent, it can be used as a diluent. So, and when mannitol, the interesting thing with the mannitol is, if you are using the mannitol as a sweetening agent, it gives cooling sensation in the mouth. So this is the one of the property. So it can be used as a sweetener to make the, there are several preparations with the mint, like polo and all these things. So they also contains mannitol as a sweetening agent because it is having the cooling sensation as well. So this particular mannitol, it is giving the cooling sensation. It is suitable diluent, and it is a suitable for the moisture sensitive drug. Mannitol also helps in the direct compression as well as weight granulation. So it reduces apart from that, the mannitol is also having one therapeutic effect. If there is a case of the brain hemorrhage, so in that there will be cerebral edema, as well as it is going to increase the intracranial pressure, means pressure built up within the skull. So mannitol injections are given, parenteral dose is given for the mannitol, and this particular mannitol is going to counteract the intracranial pressure, or as well as it is helpful in treating the cerebral edema. So these are the so many uses of mannitol. So definitely it can be used as a diluent, as well as thickening agent or plasticizer in soft gelatin capsules, or we can say that diluent in the oral dispersible tablet or chewable tablets. So likewise, there are so many uses of mannitol. So this is also the one of the diluent, natural diluent we can say. So likewise, almost we have gone through the 2 to 3 examples of natural diluent. Apart from that, there are so many other diluents like calcium carbonate. It is obtained from the mineral source, we can, if we talk about, as well as kaolin, sodium alginate. In certain cases, sucrose can be used as a diluent if the calorie is not a problem with the formulation. So sucrose can be also used as a diluent, or sorbitol, xylitol. So all these things can be used as a diluent, or microcrystalline cellulose, as we talked about earlier, that is cellulose derivatives, CMC or MCC, carboxymethyl cellulose and microcrystalline cellulose. So this complete our part, diluent.